Already have premium on it, okay.
All right, looks like KEG is picking NT and what type TC is on the other side. So we're just winning on one. Here we go. NT and one type TC. I is 4, 5. Chieftain, object 279E, I is 7, 5 again, and another I 7. Boom, let's go across the street. Alright, looks like Ken's got a trio of I is 7s. E4, it's 4, Chieftain, and a Valor, pretty much the same on the other side as well. Alright, looks like they're setting up over here at B. I have two tanks at A. I have a noticed a few things. I said it was going down Banana Road, setting up the shop right there. It's a good defensive position, as well as the defense on B. So kudos to everybody. Alright, looks like all these guys are going up this hill. Looks like they're going to press. Also looks like the other guys are holding over there at the Banana Road for a delayed push. So I can speculate. If they decide to go down, that push is going to happen. I'm trying to get them to rotate with that one tank on the outskirts of the one line. Ooh, this might just work. He's sacrificing himself for the better of his team. That's when they decide to push. That is a fantastic idea. Great job, Keg. Keg's pushing up. He's been spotted. Now the brawl's gonna happen. Looks like Samurai got hit. Got hit by I7. Ooh, there it is. Double team. Just soaking up the damage. Not no one. It's face hugged. These guys need to hit their target, man. He's just getting pummeled without anybody doing the correct amount of damage. There we go. E4 hitting the ISO. Got Sinifri going in, getting that damage. He also got KEG in that cap. Splitting the team up in two. And then having massive face-to-face brawls with both teams. Good job killing the I-7 for KEG. Smart the I-7. Getting that wonderful side shot to end. Tracked him at least. Hits. There goes Spartan. Good job, guys. KEG has done a great job splitting up this team. So not he's having that wacky hole in the front. He's giving us some good defensive bounces there. Looks like over here on the right side, the Chieftain went down, as well as IS4, but they're pulling a hell of a good fight over here. Oh, he is sideways, jeez. Goes around, and then he goes down. The IS7 over here, nice side hit. He needs to get that damage in. We're gonna take him out. Oh, and he misses. And he's gonna get taken down. Look at the IS4 up in the front. Got the guys on the right. Yep, there we go. Oh, and he goes down by the FJ705. Face hug with the Valor. Five. Ooh, and he catches on fire with a lucky hit from the side. Good job, Storm, getting that lucky hit in. Catching him off fire. Sydney Free goes down over there in the cap, which is the highest four. This is a good match. Just bullying him, pushing him out in the open, and taking him out. Good job, NT. What's that, TC? Good job, both teams. It's always a little flipping scoreboard. We got NT, one tech TC with a 2705 A's for 200 damage and 3500. We got the Object 268 with the 2500 damage. We got the Chieftain with 2400 damage. We got the IS7 doing 2300 damage, and the IS4 with 1500. Object 279E only with 1293, and then of course the last IS7 with the 499. Good job for NT with that damage spread. It's pretty much even all the way across. And then over here on the KEG side, we got the E4 doing 3900 damage, doing good damage for his team. We got the IS-7 doing 2,300 damage, the Valor 2,051, the IS-7 with 1,774, or 73, my bad. Got the IS-4 doing 1,290, Chieftain only doing 1,000. We got that Valor with 910, and then the IS-7 with the donuts. So, good job both teams for giving a good fight up. Switch sides, and I'm gonna ready up, get this next game going. I have not seen or played versus KEG, but I hear they're pretty decent. So,
they're in this thing. Am I sitting this one out?
Just like all of us.
Okay.
So, let's see what they can, how well they can, get
go.
Into this, and then, you know, split into the actual being a name team. To see how well they evolve over time. That's what I'm really trying to say. Alright, they're already doing their tank picks. Four, we're just waiting for the rest to pick. So this game, get this game going on. You got little monkeys in the background screaming downstairs. So if you hear it, not bad. Alright, looks like they're almost finished up. We have 2, 4, 6 ready. Over there on KEG side, we have 2, 4, 6, 7 ready on the one tag and NT side. So just getting ready to get those final picks in and we get this thing started. Alright, looks like NT and one tag TC are ready to go, and then it looks also like KEG is also ready to go. Boom, there we go. Game is set.
Oh yeah, I need to mute my
starting. So let's see what they do differently. They go to B or they go to A. B defense is a lot different than A defense. Alright, KEG is on the defense. Let's see what these guys got. We got an E3 from Captain Hunter Wolf. Wolf Hunter. We got double IS-7s, one IS-4. E4, Super Crown Valor, and 50B. Not my choice of tanks on the defense, but I'm not playing, so. Alright, let's go over here, NT. And one tech TC, we got the 705, two machines, other 7, 279E, 5A, E4. four Kaizen and another Sigma 5. So it looks like they're gonna go attack B. Another B rush. So I'm not gonna pay attention to the other side of the map because nothing's gonna go on over there. We're gonna go where the action is. So it looks like, I don't know if they were spotted or not. Guess not. Oh, this is the perfect opportunity for NT. And with ITC, just a pile through there. And just cause massive damage as fast as you can possibly. So they got the 705 A's moving up. Was it the IS7s? No, they're there. And here we go. There's the fight. 705A gets that first shot in through his side of the I-7. Samurai's trying to get out of there, but I don't think he's going to make it. We got that Valor over here getting in the fight. Getting his first shot in. Ooh, and he gets hit by the ammo. Doesn't explode, but still gets hit. Looks like the 50B is going to start getting into the fight. Better do something before those machines cap them out. Ooh, that 705 is doing great damage versus that Valor. Oh, and the IS-7 gets hit, needs ammo, or not ammo wreck, it catches on fire! Hopefully he doesn't die here. The machine's moving in, getting that 50B. There's that damage we're looking at. And the 50B goes down. Both of the machines are on reload, one gets hit, needs ammo wreck. Hopefully he does not turn that corner because the IS-4 will take him out. Over here, the cap, they are pushing. Totally forgot about this tank destroyer over here. This E4 behind him is just devastating him in the back. Got Reaper coming for him, pushing upward, hopefully get some damage in. And he hits him for an E. Good hit. Machines look like fully loaded, moving on to the IS4. Gets hit in the ammo wreck. Looks like he's gonna get clipped out. Oh, and he did not. There goes the E4. KEG is putting up a hell of a fight here. Trying to keep this defense going. Doing the best I can. Looks like this E3 is going over here. And he pops him in a Cypher 7.2. Good shot. The IS-7 just needs to stay alive. And Stormcloud goes down. If Filler stays alive through this whole ordeal, that E3 can just pop shots in these guys' sides and actually do some damage. But I'm also gonna worry about that 705 behind them. So hopefully that E3 is paying attention. This was not a good move by KEG to fight the 705A. But the E3 hits the E4, hit him with ammo and great shot, but does not fully detonated his ammo rig. Machine's pushing the IS-4 and takes him down. E3 takes out the machine with a great shot. Hoping he can assist without getting killed in the next few seconds. The IS-7 has put up a great frontal defense versus the 75A. Using his explosive rounds to do some damage over here. And it looks like they capped out. So they got defeated this round. So good job, KEG, putting up the great defense. We're an MVP doing 4,900 damage this game. You did fantastic. Getting all your shots as much as you can. Try to protect that gap. That's your game. So we'll go down the damage. KEG in the E3. Captain Wolf. Didn't do enough 4,900 damage, getting that MVP of the round. Got the IS-4 doing 2,093. Got the Supercon with 1,895. Valor doing 1,630. IS-7 doing 1,538. Bulldozer in the E-4 doing 1,000 damage. 50B only doing 720. And you get the IS7 doing 485. Over here on the winner side, the NT and one tech TC with the E4 doing 3,800 damage. You got the 705A and Black Stars tank pick, 3,700 damage. You got Rage and the Machine doing 2,244. You got that WZ5A doing 2,200 damage. The Object 279E doing 2,069. Stormcloud and Object 705 doing 1,900. And you got Canvent in the Machine doing 939. And then you got Going Postal in the i7 doing a big fat donut. So great job on both of the teams for putting up a great fight. Then we go back to the garage, switch maps, and then we'll go on to the next round. Looks like they want mines. This is gonna be a tough one. I haven't seen mines in a hot minute. But this one's extremely difficult to do. You gotta just play it smart for defense and offense. Make two months. More unnecessary moves on this map, you can just potentially lose a map with in a snap. Like KEG is already starting to pick their tanks. They already know what they're doing. So, with that last map pick, I'm pretty sure that was with one NT, one tech NT, NC, and NT's map. Jesus Christ, I can't talk today. And now it's KEG's map. They're readying it up real quick. I guess they're more comfortable with this map than one tech TC and NT. See what they do with this map. I'm very interested in seeing what's gonna happen. Like the picking is taking a while. I don't know if the NT or one tech TC have played in this map recently, but it is on map pick, so people gotta change their maps. So every week we should be seeing a different map being played, hopefully. Not people getting comfortable with one map, because if you do that, you're just gonna ignore all the other ones and then put yourself in a bad situation when that map does come up. Alright, it looks like we're getting close to the end of these map picks over there in the NT and one tech TC side. Looks like both teams are ready to go. Let's get this on. Let's go. Just an FYI, I am participating in the ITW. I am streaming the games as well. I am not overviewing the games. I have records of them, so if you guys want these, your games streamed, kept on record, let me know. I am going to compress all the files, and whenever I figure out my YouTube shit, I will upload it for you guys, so you guys are able to see. So it looks like NT, One Tech, DC are on defense, and KEG is on the offense. So we are on NT and One Tech, DC side. They got a Supercock, Mouse, Chieftain, E6, Taran, Supercock, E5, and another Supercock. So they're doing that triple threat. Then over here on the KEG side, I got the Bat Chat. There's two machines, I7, E4, Grill 15, Supercock, and that Chieftain. See what happens. Got that Taran over there moving in the back area. You got these Bat Chats machines pushing up here on the right, trying to get around that hill. You got tanks already taking shots. Hopefully they don't get popped. Oh my god, there goes the machine getting half his health taken out. That you got Keg over there in the middle of the map taking it over, getting those shites side shots in. Kudos to y'all, punish them. You control that middle, you can punish anybody. It's facing the other direction, or you can face upward because it's a downward slope. You're just getting having a feel for those shots. If I was Captain Wolf, I'd be pushing up right now. I wouldn't be afraid to take that damage on the end slap, just in order to take a tank out. Oh, he fires and bounces off the side. Looks like NT is losing a good amount of hit points. Same thing with KEG. These machines and Badger. Taran just fired and missed. Got the machines shooting up this side. There we go, getting their shots. Wow. Chieftain goes down on the NT side. Oh, there goes the Supercon for NT. I totally forgot about those Mouse and E5. They're over here defending on the right side of the map. Versus one. Two tanks at the room 15 and get the ice over there. But now what you guys gotta worry about is getting shot from the top. Three other tanks are taken out in the middle of the map. These machines are just loading on the guys in the middle. So Supercon just went down. Chieftain's over there. Got spotted. And he's pushing back. He was on the tapped out by that Dutch Ram. Taran's looking. Machine gets taken out by the Mouse and Supercon. Great shots. And there is a Taran. Getting that final shot in the E4 and taking him out. Great job. The E5 and the IS7 over here fighting each other one-on-one. That's what I like to see. But now the Chieftain can see him in the very back. Get those shots down the hill. And there he goes. Not the move I would have taken, but the Mouse is now turning around. What a good job. Gets hit to the ammo rack. IS7 hits him in the ammo rack. Jeez, everybody's gonna hit in the ammo rack today. This is what teamwork is right here. Two teams going down, giving it to him for E5. Taking his lunch money. But now they gotta worry about that Mouse with a 3,000 hit point. Tank versus that team. All right, Bat Chat, Supercon moving in. Ooh, and the Taran takes out the Chieftain. Bat Chat coming around to that Taran, fully loaded. Hopefully, he can take him out. Oh massive hit by that Terang. Terang is taken out. I7's backing up a little bit. I guess he's gonna eat that shot. Ooh, and he takes that shot and hits his stride. So the only thing NT has left is that mouse. Hopefully he can stay alive long enough to do some damage. And he takes out the ISM. Great job. So one versus three, who will win? Supercontact hits him with track. And here comes the rest of his buddies. Bat Jet's almost fully loaded. He's gonna get behind him and then do as much damage as possible he can. So there's nothing this mouse can do. He's out, man. So we will look at the damage roll. So we got NT with TC and the Terran doing 3900 damage. Good job. Mouse getting his damage in with 3338. Got the E5 doing 1491. E6 at 1170. At Supercon doing 1158. Chieftain doing 804. And then we got the both Supercons on the very bottom only doing 409 and 387 damage. So over here on the winning side, we got that Bat Chat doing 6,000 damage. Great freaking job on Keg side, getting that flop of damage and winning the game for them. Great job. All right, okay, we got the Chieftain doing 2,300, Supercon doing 2,300 as well. Got the E4 doing 2,295. Both of the machines pulling out a great amount of damage, 2,000 and 1,480. Got the IS-7 doing 1,453, and then you got the Grow only doing 658, but he stayed alive until the end of the game. So great job on both teams. Now we're gonna go back to the garage. Keg decided not to lose this round, so now we're going to round four. So by the time we get back, Keg already knows what they're doing. They're picking their tanks. Got NT and one tech TC. Starting to pick slower, but they're probably recalibrating the strategy on this one. Alright, looks like both teams are ready to go. Got the majority of all the tanks picked already. Looks like they don't know what they're doing. Just waiting for them to start this game. Let's go. Let's see if we get the ghost town. Let's not see this. Let's hurry up and end this. I'm just kidding. All right. Alright, here we go. Let's get out of this view. We can figure this crap out. I guess it's not gonna let me out. Alright, there we go. Holy crap, I got him stuck in a freaking third person view for a minute. Was the NT and Wentai TC are taking the A attack. Got that 275 A's in the mouse. Oh, just 279 E double I7 in the Terran again. They got that achieved in the middle. Looks like KEG has taken a different defensive approach. Staying in that back area with that Supercom E4. Both tight ballers. Right, it's wearing the optic 705. And it looks like they're working their way around with the machine and bad chat. Ooh, look at that. ISM just caught some good damage across the map. Hitting that Valor type. And he gets hit again. The 705. Great shot. Was that the bad chat and machine pushing up to the back way? So they better be careful. Ice-4 finally gets hit. And gets hit again with the high explosive round. Supercon getting up there. Hopefully getting behind him. Start pumping shots. Bad chat and the machine are behind him. Ooh, the Supercon's gonna get his damage in as soon as he peeks. As soon as the Chieftain makes that bad move, he's gonna start shooting. In there with the Terran. There it is. Chieftain is just getting pummeled. Bad positioning due to that Supercon in the middle. Chieftain's pumping round after round, trying to hit that machine, and the Terran hits that bad chat for a good amount. Takes out that machine as well. But they are not giving up. Ooh! Bad chat just fired and hit his track and did no damage. Ooh, looks like the bad chat's about to go down. Supercon's trying to do his best amount of damage as possible can with the spot he's in currently. E4 shoots at 705 and bounces. These guys are putting up a hell of a good defense. Same with the offensive team. They're putting up a good defense on their offense, hiding behind these rocks, as well as these undestructible houses or destructible houses. Everybody's firing hedge and high explosive rounds just so they can get those damage and destroy that building. So great job. So mixing those rounds actually helps. So one person does the explosive rounds, doesn't do so much damage to the tracks. The one behind them can actually do the damage in order to actually kill him. That was the dogfight up here. Looks like NT with FTC is moving up in the middle of the map to get these guys out of there. And they've been spotted. ISM gets slapped by that Supercon. Turning and not making a good decision. Get hit again. The E4 is right there. I don't know what he hit, but wow, there goes the Terran. Almost getting killed. Catching on fire. And there goes Terran, hit by the Valor. Looks like NTC and TTC are moving up in the cap area of the 8. Almost taken out. That's 705 and the high is 4. We got the two tanks in the middle doing the best they can. Getting the damage they need. Confusing the other team as long as humanly possible. In order to try to win this. Oh, looks like the high is 4 has been taken out. at 35 seconds left on the clock. And IS-7 has been taken out by the Valor. It's up in the middle of the map. Got 16 seconds. Only thing I gotta worry about is that E4 that is on top, because if he hits and resets that counter, they are... might as well be done, but we'll see. And the E4 gets almost killed. Not pinning his shot, making the game end right there. So great job on both teams. If he would have set and reset that counter right there, the game would not have ended the way it ended. Could have kept going on for another minute or two. So over here on the KEG side, Super God got 2,500 damage. We got the Valor doing 2,400 damage, E4 doing 2,000. We got the T95 FV4201 doing 1,300 damage, IS4 only doing 864, 705 doing 594, Bat Chat doing 351, and the Machine doing 286. On the winning side over here, NT and Wentai TC, I got the IS7 doing 2,700 damage, I'm just 705 doing 1956. Chieftain doing 1950, 705A again doing 1846, the other IS7R team doing 1686, Mouse 1540, Object 279E doing 1412, and then you got the Terran only doing 954, but they did a great job. Look at the damage spread over there on NT and Wentai TC is pretty much evened out, so great job on both of you. Looks like they got the win on this one.